Welcome again to Star Rapid, the company that does serious engineering for serious engineers.
Serious engineering.
Today I want to talk about how you as a designer can keep your cost of manufacturing as low as possible. Putting aside the obvious one of sending your parts off to a provider with a lower cost of manufacturing, the following advice deals with more practical solutions that will work anywhere in the world. One, don't skip the consultation process. I've been interacting with designers for 37 years now, and I've personally been involved in thousands of projects. And the number one thing I've learned is this. Few designers are experts in many, if any, of the production processes that they have to deal with on a daily basis. And that's completely understandable. Therefore, they should interact as early and as often as possible with experts at their intended suppliers. Before even designing any components, it's a good idea to discuss the product concept with a number of manufacturers and see what processes they think might suit the application. Then, after further consultation, you can decide how best to design each component to best suit the manufacturing process itself. In my experience, the projects that go off the rails are the ones where parts were designed without consultation and sometimes even without any manufacturing process in mind at outset. That is very dangerous. Two, design to the quantity you require. Quantity really drives which process you may use and how to design the parts. The higher the quantity, the more money you can put into the mold tools for plastic injection molding, or dies for pressure die casting, or even fixturing for CNC machining. If you're making millions of parts, the amortized cost of a very sophisticated mold tool is extremely low. But if you only want a few thousand parts per year, you've really got to keep the cost of tooling down and maybe accept a higher piece price. Three, think accuracy, not precision. In my 20s, I did a lot of design for precision machined assemblies, and yes, that was quite a long time ago. Being a precision machinist myself back then, and not owning very good machines, I knew how really difficult it was to make precision parts. So I was always looking for ways to make the assembly accurate without having to make the parts super precise. Now that sounds like a contradiction, right? Let me give you an extreme example. Wouldn't you have thought that by now you could make a car that doesn't need wheel alignment before leaving the factory? If the tire molds were accurate enough, if the rubber was consistent enough, if the steering assembly was precise enough, surely you wouldn't need to align the wheels immediately after the factory assembly. Well, you probably could, but the car would cost significantly more to make. This is an extreme example of what we call tolerance stacking. Obviously, you also need to adjust your wheel alignment after you try and impress your date in your new Lambo. Well, that's just three ways we can help you to reduce the cost of manufacturing. Tell me what you think in the comments below, and don't forget to pound that like button, subscribe, and share this video. And don't forget, we're the company that does serious engineering for serious engineers.
Serious engineering.
Side effects include your production costs go down precipitously, getting angry with people who confuse accuracy with precision, and now having to try and stay cool whilst explaining to your garage mechanic, Megan Fox, that if the car manufacturer had done their job properly in the first place, you wouldn't have to be paying for wheel alignment.
You've got a high-rise double pump carburetor. That's pretty impressive, Sam.
Double pump?
It squirts the fuel in so you can go faster.
Oh. I like to go faster. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, please, please.